Greetings, everyone. This is Michael, and welcome back to the Movie Reviews. Today's film is another sci-fi invasion movie. Surprise, surprise. But the film has basically the same themes as an earlier film that I reviewed entitled Battle LA. And speaking of Battle LA, guys, I was watching that review, and first of all, I want to thank one of my subscribers who pointed out who the lead actor was and that he had starred in, well, co-starred in The Dark Knight, because I had no memory of the guy because I seen The Dark Knight so many years ago, and you know, that immediately brought back my memories. Yeah, of course, he was Two-Face. But speaking of Battle LA, one thing that I didn't get to mention about the film that really bugged me was the shaky cam. I mean, you know, I can handle shaky cam sometimes during battle scenes, but it seems like this thing had shaky cam when people wasn't even moving. And I remember thinking, fucking shit, come on, stop with the camera. But it's like every scene, you know, they just could not be still, and that just irritated me to no end. But just thought I'd mention that, guys. I hate when I do a review and then I forget something and don't remember it until afterwards and don't get in the review, so I'm covering my ass. Okay, guys, the next film is Skyline, and I finally got around to seeing the movie, guys. My friend Jeff had seen both Battle LA and Skyline, and he actually leaned more towards liking Skyline. And Jeff and I have a lot in common. We're more science fiction oriented, whereas, you know, of course, Battle LA is science fiction. Skyline is leaning more towards science fiction, given the subject matter, in a way. This is a film, and I gotta tell you guys, I didn't recognize any of the actors other than the black actor who, surprise, surprise again, ended up dying. Okay, I'm sorry, I had to mention that, guys. I don't usually put spoilers in videos, but I had to mention that. You know, it's just us black guys, we can't stay alive in movies. But I remember him when he was younger in some role on television, but that's about the extent of my memory. The lead white guy in the film, the lead actor, I do remember seeing him in, I believe it was also a television series, so I'm not really up on him either. But the film Skyline, of course, like I said, is about an alien invasion, and the invasion comes down in the form of these bright lights. And upon closer inspection, the lead characters find out that these are not only bright light, but they are sentient creatures. And anyone that looks at these lights automatically begin to get mesmerized. They kind of just walk towards the light. Don't go into the light! How many times do we have to tell these damn people, don't go into the light? But anyway, they go into the light. And the light, like I said, is indeed creatures. And these creatures, once you head in their direction, they snatch you up with these tentacles and basically they devour you. Nothing like humans in the morning for breakfast. But yeah, the creatures devour you. But before they actually consume you, you start getting all these veins forming in your arms and in your body and everywhere. And the lead character, who probably takes the longest gaze of anybody in the film upon these creatures, he seems to be the most affected by whatever these creatures give off when they hit you with this light. So, you know, he gets pulled away from the light, and it does have an adverse effect on him that's not too prevalent in most of the film, but we find out later on how the effect was on him. Now, basically, in the story, you have two lovers heading out to see an old friend who's made it big. He's rich now. And they go to visit him. They get there, and the lights are bombarding the earth, or at least the city that they're in. And we can assume that they're also bombarding the rest of the world. But the film is spent with these people trying to survive or elude capture and consumption. I've got consumption. Consumption of these creatures. So basically you have a sci-fi chase film where these creatures are pulling out all stops to consume the human race. And I mean, you see some really huge creatures in this film. They've got one creature that's a couple of stories tall and is just vicious, ferocious. And he's also trying, or it is also trying to capture the human beings. Now, basically that's your story, guys. And it's not really a complex story. It's very, very simplistic. And as the film goes on, it kind of develops into a more sophisticated sci-fi film, something that at least I hadn't seen done before, something that is actually original. But, and I'm not going to give that end in a way, guys, but it actually morphs into something original, an original idea. So that was really kind of refreshing. And once again, the visual effects, the CGI is pretty damn good. The acting is pretty decent. And overall, guys, I enjoyed the film. I thought it was a really enjoyable film. Now, of course, people can't stop asking me, what do you like most, Battle LA or Skyline? And I'm kind of leaning towards Skyline, and that's because of the ideals that the film creates. And, you know, Skyline is a film where the military fights aliens. It's something that you see all the time, quite frankly, and I'm not dissing it for that, but Skyline, like I said, had an original idea, kind of, as far as the story goes, more flesh, something more to sink your teeth into, something to kind of make you think about, you know, because it wasn't really a surprise to me when I saw the film and the way the last act progressed. I'm like, whoa, that's what they're doing? It raised a lot of questions, and if you've seen the movie, my biggest question would be, okay, if they're using this from us, how come we don't have control over what they're doing, whereas, you know, it's, obviously the lead character did. But like I said, guys, I enjoyed Skyline. It was a pretty good experience. I had a good time with the film. If anything, what I can say that I didn't like about the movie is that in some points it seemed more like a television miniseries, and I'm sure a lot of that was due with the limited scope of the film. There wasn't a lot of money given to this movie, and it was directed by the Strause brothers, who, I gotta tell you, sometimes their films aren't executed the greatest, but they do have some unique ideas, and if they could just polish the script just a little bit more and got a bigger budget, I think they'd have done a much more remarkable job with the material. But as it stands, it's kind of a claustrophobic sci-fi film, which is supposed to take place on a large scale across the world, but you never really get that epic large scale feel that you got in, take for instance, Battle LA. And I could also say that the way the film ended was kind of a disappointment to me. I mean, you bring up this really, really intriguing idea at the very end of the film, and you don't get a chance to explore it. So that was kind of a disappointment. I wish they had cut the film in half and put that ending right in the middle and explored it a little bit further. But other than that, guys, I found the picture very enjoyable. Some of the characters were really getting on my nerves. The security guard who was just, you know, trying to take control of everybody, tell everybody what to do. I couldn't help but think, dude, don't stop me. If I want to fucking go outside and say, hey, bon appetit, leave me the fuck alone. It's not your business to tell me what to do. That guy was really getting on my nerves, and so was the girlfriend. Ugh. But anyway, guys, like I said, enjoyable movie. Definitely got to recommend this along with Battle LA. Two surprisingly entertaining films. The Strauss brothers have went on record to say that they will make a sequel to this film. A sequel is coming, even if they have to spend their own money, because they feel like they have questions to answer, and so do I. Because the film really left a lot of tremendous questions. Now, of course, if they don't make a sequel, it'll probably gain a cult following for the simple fact that you don't have all those answers. As far as gore and all that is concerned, there is a little bit of gore, not a whole bunch. But like I said, guys, a thoroughly enjoyable picture, which is unfortunately very limited given its low budget. So guys, thanks for watching. I appreciate all the people that take the time to watch the videos. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you at the next The Movie Reviews. Take care.